Hello everyone, and welcome back to another part of Let's Play Banjo Kazooie. I'm very sorry that this has been off put for so long now, but like I've said recently in other videos, I've been generally busy with a lot of other stuff, mainly with skill and a bunch of other stuff, and I never meant to use the golden pepper spear, but whatever. But this game is actually done and it's sitting on my hard drive, and it's just, all I really need to do is upload it, but to do that I need to basically make the commentary for it, and I just haven't had time to sit down and basically record, you know, like 30 minutes of commentary, and it's basically, you know, like 30 minutes per level of commentary, and it's just like, what am I doing type of thing. I mean, I really don't want to say this. In some ways, other people are like rushing ahead of me because of the fact that I'm being like so slow when it comes to this. And I've had this done since September, and it's, well, it's September, what am I saying? Like, I came back from America and on July 24th, I believe, 20 something, anyway, and like, I did this August, like, 1st to the 15th, I believe. It only took me, like, a week or so to get this done. Maybe a week, 2 weeks, maybe? Like, I'm just guessing that it was between the 1st and the 15th. And other people are rushing ahead of me now, and it's just, like, I'm just going, I have it done, I could be up to this point. People could be watching my stuff too, but why am I taking so long? And it's not like I'm being arrogant and saying I want all the views that they are getting and stuff like that, just because of the fact that I feel like, you know, I've got this done but nobody can see it, and they would respect me for getting it done quicker if I did, especially with a higher quality that I produce and stuff besides the commentary, because I don't respect my commentary as much as I respect theirs. It's just like, I don't know, it just kind of feels right to me that I feel like I'm losing a lot of attention span for like people that watch my stuff because I'm being so slow. But then again, if I'm slow, then wouldn't that mean that you guys respect it more when it actually comes out? I really don't know. A few people might be able to catch on by what I mean by when I'm referring to other people. I mean, there's two or three people playing Banjo Kazooie all at once, and it's like, yeah, there's only one person I really watch who actually like produces their videos of Banjo Kazooie, but heck, I'm done with it. I don't watch it because of the fact that I'm stuck and I don't know what to do, or I'm looking for something in specific. It's just the fact that I'm sitting here going through everything. Like, everything in my life is just consuming time, and I don't really find that much time to upload. Oh gosh, I'm already 2 minutes and almost 3 minutes, actually. Yeah, 3 minutes, man. End of the video. Wow. Alright, so I've already got one jiggy and like 30 notes, I believe. Yeah, I've already hit the buttons on the snowman, which give me a bunch of stuff. And oh, I sucked. Then I landed on the snow, luckily. If I landed in the water, I would have just took damage instantly, but I'm glad that I landed on the snow. It's weird, I always thought it was weird that you bounce off a snowman if you miss it. Like, if you tap him in the wrong place other than the X on her head, then you just kind of bounce off him. Like I did there when I hit his X, but I just kind of like backwards, do a little backflip and land on whatever, you know, is nearby. But yeah, I'm kind of glad that I noticed. Where to, like, readjusting my aim. The first time I ever do this, like, you know, like, after I've not played the game in a while, it's so awkward to actually get aiming correct, but after I get it down again, just once, it's like instantaneously knowing when to push B is, or, you know, like, in this case, X, which just makes the game so much easier in some sense. So maybe you guys will be like that as well. I mean, it's not really hard, you just kind of judge where Kazooie is and then push X, and wherever Kazooie is normally where you hit, like her head, whatever she's in line with, when the way you're right, yeah, when the way that you're aiming isn't normally what you hit. Wow, jeez, I just spoke a mouthful. Okay, so you fly all the way up to the top, and notice that your feathers might be incredibly raw. Whoa, especially if you haven't put a red feather sheen, which you can't really get until you do Mammoth's Mansion. So, unless you want to do the levels out of order just to get red feathers, there is not really a point. So that's two jiggies, and there's a bunch of notes around the rim of the snowman's hat, on top of it anyway. And this little, god, hexagon? Yeah, hexagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I believe that's 6 points, but I can't really see because the hexagon is too big to actually notice. 1, 2, free. I believe I just go down. What? I collected all the eggs? Oh, I just felt like collecting one more. I'm a present given me to someone said. Yeah, so you give these to Boggy's kids. Boggy's the little guy that we met, you know, the snow polar bear thing. Like, what am I saying? The polar bear that we've seen who was lying on his back, saying that, you know, his stomach hurt and all that kind of stuff, and you can't really help him because of the fact that he hears a jiggy and say to him, he ate a jiggy. Because he's mentally retarded. I don't know. You really don't have to, you know, like, come down here and get a ginger like I'm doing. You can actually jump across to it, but I guess I just never really wanted to show that, but I can't actually remember if I did or not. Like, yeah, you can. I think I'm trying to get an angle right, but you see, you know, like, it keeps screwing up. You can just, like, flutter across here and walk over. You don't have to fly to it. See, I only collected that one note and not the other ones behind me because I'm gonna come up with Scarf later on, and there's not really a point in me walking down a scarf just to come back up again. And that's 3 jigsaw pieces. And on we go. Actually, what am I doing it now? Okay, see, this is what it's awkward with. I mean, I hardly ever basically just... It's hard to explain. I hardly ever, like, remember what I do, you know, when I'm playing the game and I do after commentary. I don't normally do after commentary with my games, but, you know, like, if I have recorded basically a video a long time ago and I've done commentary for it, you know, over when I was doing it, I tend to think, you know, I can do this better. I can basically re-record my audio and then, you know, publish it easier and much more efficient than what I did have planned originally. Okay, so that's 59 notes and 29 red feathers. So that's me restocking on my red feathers because I need them drastically at this point. Kazooie jumping is actually faster in most cases, believe it or not. See? Like, watch. Kazooie jumping. Get an angle right and just pay attention. Kazooie slides. Like, and she gives you a bit of a boost a lot faster than what you would normally get. I really don't feel comfortable doing Kazooie jumping right there. Go down the scarf on, you know, like, the slide here, the little sledge, and land on Boggy. Oof! That's better. Hey, you found my sweat. I'll go practice for the big race. See you, buddy. So, he goes away. And basically, we can grab this chicky now. That's here. Ba-dum, bum, bum, ba-dum, ba-dum, bum. And then we slip. So, it's 4 jigsaw pieces already. So, you jump. Get that Ecom token. Oh, I know. 60 notes. So the water is too cold for you, Banjo. Well, stay out, then. 63. Over this way. Oh, crap. See, I should have water glided, but oh well. That's the green Jinju. Oh, I slid off the house and I never meant to. I'm gonna be standing here, if you notice, and, like, backflip onto the chimney. Get on top of the flying pad. There's a present down there. You can see it. You can see it in this version because the draw distance in the Xbox 360 is a lot bigger than that of the Nintendo 64 version. 66 notes. So I'm gonna go grab that present now, I think. Yeah, I am. Gonna jump across. Grab it. There we go. Brr. It's cold. It's warm backpack for me, too. Okay. And a Mumbo token. Ecom token. Mumbo token. Okay. I need those red feathers. I'm just gonna, like, try and get across here as best I can, really. Press the Gruntilda switch, opens up that in the advent calendar. Which is basically, if you don't know what an advent calendar is, I'm not sure if you get them in the United States or anywhere else in the world, really. But if you don't know what an advent calendar is, what it is basically, you get a calendar with all of the days in December of that year, or up to New Year in some cases as well. And basically, each day that goes by of that day, like, say, the 1st of December, you open it up and you take the chocolate out of it, and you eat the chocolate that's inside the calendar. Believe it or not, that's what kids actually do when it comes to Christmas time around here in Scotland, and then in the United Kingdom itself. I believe everywhere in the United Kingdom does have an advent calendar for kids when they're young. And that seal, or walrus, I should say, is going in there. If you would say for once to come out now. Okay, what was I saying? Oh yeah, advent calendars. But I'm not sure if, you know, there are stuff like that around in the United States and other European countries. Okay, so these are Twinkies. They get eaten by green little monsters that come out of the holes in a certain little wooden pathway here. Like, that thing behind me. And basically what you need to do is basically peck them. And each time you get eaten, like, they won't get anywhere, basically. Another one will come out of the box each time either it goes into the tree or it gets eaten. So, the object here is to protect them so they get to the tree. Twinkies are basically Christmas tree lights. And, crap, I screwed up. Okay, this is 5, okay. Ah, crap, I ate it again. I'm surprised it didn't get eaten there, but okay. Damn it, got eaten. There we go. All the Twinkies have made it. And on the back of the tree now is an on switch, which we need to tap with eggs. Okay. Yippee! Be a star and you'll find a reward. Hurry. Okay. So we need to go up to the reward and fly through the star and fly through it a couple of times. Sorry about that. A little bit dazed and distracted. Distracted by what? I really don't know because I'm looking at a video. Ugh. So we're almost about halfway through the video now. Of this level. Can't believe it went that fast. I mean, that's, if I was, you know, YouTube time limited, I would have, like, shit, I'd have a part done already. Just one part and I already have like half the stuff I need. I don't know. I guess it just worked fast. It's like ironic with the fact that I said if I work really slow earlier. But I do upload really slow. It's just I'm always really lazy. I never set things up at night. When I go to my bed, I normally use the render when I went to my bed. So it's just a case of like setting up my render files. Go to bed. When I wake up in the morning, they're done. I upload them. I go to school or whatever, you know, I was meant to be doing at the time. Come back. Everything's uploaded. Titles are all screwed up. People are complaining that the titles are screwed up. I rename the titles when I come back. And fix them. Everyone's happy and everyone starts watching and commenting. That was pretty much it. Shame I lost that account, but, you know, shit happens, especially with YouTube and you do video games. But whatever with that, I mean, it wasn't really a big deal to me. At the time, anyway. Yahoo? Okay. But, now I'm actually quite glad that happened because I have a director's account and I can upload a certain amount, you know, like, of megabytes and, oh, megabytes, gigabytes, so I can upload to 20 gigabytes and unlimited time amount, so it can be a really crappy video with like 10 days worth of footage, or like a really high quality video with like, I don't know, an hour, maybe two worth of footage. Okay, what do I need to do now? Forget where I'm going. Let's think. I think it's time to transform, I'm not sure. I would say it is, actually. There's nothing really I can do. Until we go back and see Boggy again as the walrus that is the transformation of this level. So, here we go. Here's Mumbo. It's 15 tokens to transform. I have 34. On top of here, there's a Jinjo and a bunch of notes. So we're gonna walk around. Grab a bunch of crap. I have no idea how I'm gonna do Banjo Tooie. I mean, like with commentary, because it's gonna take like, shit, an hour apart. So if I do postpone commentary, where it's like afterwards commentary, it's just gonna be all day. Banjo gone all fag, got big teeth, her. So, like, it's just gonna be a nightmare for recording that. I mean, yeah, I'm already halfway through the video of this one, but